In the lower east rift zone of Kilauea, where we have had intermittent active lava and spatter emission for the past number of days, last night was fairly quiet. There was no active eruption of lava or spatter. However, there still is vigorous degassing occurring, so very high levels of sulfur dioxide gas exist in the immediate vicinity of the fissures and downwind. That remains an important hazard of concern. We are also continuing to see ongoing earthquake activity and deformation of the ground that suggests that magma is still moving downrift from beneath the Leilani Estates area further into the lower east rift zone. So as we've been saying since the beginning of this event down there, we anticipate additional outbreaks of lava. They could be within the zone that has already been affected, or they could be along other portions of the rift zone further to the east or to the west. We have ground crews in the area working with local response authorities to track activity and look for evidence of new outbreaks that would guide civil defense decisions about further public alerts and evacuations. We certainly don't know exactly how long it will last, but the historical precedents, most recently the 1955 and 1960 eruptions in that similar area, lasted between 36 and 88 days. So that gives you a sense of the bounds of what is plausible.
Thank you. And do you think there's any chance there's going to be any of that dramatic lava fountaining that went on in like in 1984?
The answer is yes, that is possible. If fresh, gassier, hotter magma arrives at the surface during this eruption, we would expect higher lava fountaining.
The next question in the queue is from Chris Leonard with KWXX. Your line is now open.
All right. There's been a number of earthquakes east of Leilani. I'm wondering if that's, in your opinion, if that's indicative of additional magma movement into that area, and as a result, what the potential is for perhaps more eruptive activity heading east of Leilani or down Pohuiki Road area.
Wes?
Right. So, indeed, we are seeing earthquakes. They are clustering right now. Near the intersection of Highway 132 and Nani Farms Road. That evidence, in concert with the GPS evidence from a station in the area, gives us pretty good confidence that magma is, in fact, has moved down rift from where it was pooled under Leilani Estates, and at least part of what was there under Leilani Estates has moved at least as far down as Nani Farm Road. The implications for that are obviously that there is an increased likelihood for fissuring above the area that has been intruded, but we have very little constraint on the exact timing of that right now. We also don't really have a good understanding of exactly how far this may go down rift or if it may stall out where it is now.